Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
All peace from on high and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
All peace in the whole world, for the stability of the Holy Church of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy church and whoever, for all who enter with faith, reverence, and fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Holy Mother Francis, Pope of Rome, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, for God, loving Bishop Kurt, for the better world, for spirit, the diaconate in Christ, and all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our government and for all the service of our country, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city, community, and the faithful living in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who travel by sea or land, for the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Thank you,
Lord. Lord our God, mighty beyond description, glorious above all understanding, merciful without limits, loving us all beyond expression, look with compassion on us and on this holy church, O Master, and show us and those who pray with us the riches of your tender mercy. For to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is to all glory, honor, and worship now and ever and forever.
Oh, my being.
O Lord, for the righteous have vanished.
You, O Lord, will keep us and preserve us forever, forever, from this generation.
Wisdom.
A reading from the letters to the Hebrews.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, Lord of the old established from the earth, heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain all of them and grow old like a garment. You will roll them up like a cloak. Like a garment they will be changed, but you are the same and your years have been the same. To which the angels has God ever said, sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool. Are they not ministering spirits sent to serve you, those who are the inherent salvation? In view of this, we must attend all to the more that we have heard, lest we drift away. For if the world, spoken through the angels, stood unchanged, and all the transgressions and disobedience received in due pain and punishment, how shall we escape if we ignore a salvation as great as ours, announced first by the Lord? It was confirmed to us by those who have heard him.
Peace be to you, reader. Wisdom be attentive.
Alleluia.
Good evening. Everybody was in first grade at one point or another, some of us in first grade many more years ago than others. Person, place, or thing. A noun is a person, place, or thing. What is the difference between a common noun and a proper noun? A common noun versus a proper noun. John?
One's capitalized, one's not.
Okay, which one is capitalized? The proper noun. The noun that is the name of a particular person, place, or thing. The Washington Monument. Father Tom. The church. Not St. Thomas Church, not the church on St. George's Avenue, but the church, the mystical body of Christ. Why do I do this review with you? I read something very sad last Monday. It was a statement posted by the pop singer Madonna's brother-in-law in response to the death of Madonna's older brother, Anthony. In some ways, what he said was touching. He said, "Farewell then, Brother Anthony. I want to thank the God, lowercase g, your blessed mother and mine believed in. I want to thank the God, your blessed mother and mine believed in, has her there waiting to receive you. At least for today, no one shall dissuade me from this vision." Lowercase g. It seems that to Job, this God believed in by his mother and Madonna's mother is no more than a quaint image concocted to comfort him in his time of grief. Just another god, no more real than the ancient Greek gods. And isn't this so indicative of our times and becoming more prominent? People have rejected and thrown away God and are doing, capital G God, and are doing so in great numbers. And keep in mind that the man who wrote this is 60-something, if not a 70-something. He's not an 18-year-old or a 25-year-old. We have to face it. There are so many lapsed Catholics. There are so many ex-Catholics. Look at the empty pews. I know we have a good number of people today, comparatively speaking. And each of you, I am sure, have friends, children, grandchildren, other family members, neighbors, and co-workers who are not here, nor are they in their neighborhood churches. How did we get here? There's no one reason. There are many, but for me, three stand out. First, we haven't done a good job catechizing. Second, for many, regular attendance at liturgy or at the Roman Catholic Mass was not so much grounded in fully immersing ourselves in the prayer of the liturgy, praising and thanking God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and fully attending to the sacred scriptures or fully appreciating what we receive when we come forward for Holy Communion. Rather, it is attended out of habit. There's recitation and chanting of prayers. And thirdly, belief in God has been replaced, at least in our part of the world, let's face that too, in Western Europe primarily, and in North America, it's been replaced by the heretical idea that I am my own God. Everybody wants to make his own rules, or her own rules. And we know what would happen if baseball players did that. Baseball would cease to be the beautiful melding of individual and team effort that it is. I know Joe Jenis, of blessed memory, would be rolling in his grave abolished all the rules and said it was up to each individual player. Should we be surprised that church attendance has plummeted in the wake of the pandemic lockdown? It's clear proof that people's relationships with the living God in our culture, has generally been very tenuous in recent years. It did not take much to weaken, if not sever, whatever relationship many people had with Jesus and his mystical body in the church, whose liturgy with its praise of God, sacred scripture, and the holy mystery of the Eucharist cannot compete in many households with Sunday sports, morning news shows, or just plain old sleeping in. Jesus has been relegated to a wise teacher, in fact, nothing more. God the Father has become a lowercase generic God, and the Holy Spirit only forgotten. But be attentive to the words of sacred scripture, and pray the prayers of our liturgy thoughtfully and from your heart. And your heart and soul will be filled with the reality of the living God. Today's reading from Hebrews, the letter to the Hebrews, which is actually a homily to the Hebrews, whose author we are not sure of. But this portion of this homily that we heard today points to Jesus as the Son of God. No mere prophet, no mere angel is Jesus. And the writer of Hebrews draws from the Psalms. Lord of old, you established the earth and the heavens by the works of your hands. They will perish, but you will remain. You are the same, and your years will have no end. Which of the angels has he ever said, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies your footstool? Are they not all ministering spirits sent to serve, sent to those who are to inherit salvation? The prophets and the angels, say the writer of Hebrews, were sent by God to serve us. And then we are given very wise advice. For the writer of Hebrews says, in view of this, we must attend all the more to what we have heard, lest we drift away, as so many people in our time have drifted away. For if the words spoken through angels stood unchanged, and all transgression and disobedience received its just punishment, how shall we escape if we ignore its salvation as great as ours? How can we afford to throw away such a great treasure? Be attentive, brothers and sisters, at the end of today's divine liturgy. Sing from your hearts. And sing loudly. And pay attention to these words right now, and then pay attention later. We have seen the true light. We have received the heavenly spirit, and We have found the true faith, and we worship the undivided Trinity. The Trinity has saved us. The Trinity has saved us. We have seen the true light. We should be causing the windows to vibrate, especially with the number of people here today. And reverberate the outside of St. George's Avenue. What is the power of Jesus as we move toward Holy Week and Pascha? In today's reading from Mark, Jesus healed the paralytic body and soul. And what a scene it must have been. Everybody crowding into Jesus' home to hear him read the Word of God and preach and teach. And four men struggling to get a paralyzed man on a stretcher into the house so Jesus might heal him. They were so desperate. They were so desperate that they resorted to removing the roof so that they couldn't lower him, so that they could lower him into the house. Imagine if that happened here. Pews were filled and people were pushing to come in because they knew what they would be hearing in the Word of God and receiving in the Eucharist. And Jesus saw the faith of the paralytic and the faith of the four men who were struggling to get him into the house, into Jesus' house. And before healing the man of his paralysis, having seen his faith in the faith of the four men, he said to the man, "Child, your sins are forgiven." These were healing words that allowed him, the paralytic, to move forward in his life, in spite of all his sinfulness, to move forward without looking back, helping to make God's kingdom present now and assured the promise of everlasting life, which is precisely what happens to us in the sacrament of reconciliation. So, brothers and sisters, proclaim loudly, I want to hear it. We have seen the true light. Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory, Father.
Let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty God, our fathers, we pray you here and have mercy. God, according to your great mercy, we pray you hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, for Most Reverend Metropolitan William, for our God-loving Bishop Courage, for those who serve and have served in this Holy Church, for our spiritual fathers and for all our brothers and sisters in Christ. Service of our country.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Well, again, we pray for the people here present who await your great and abundant mercy, for those who show us mercy and for all Christians of the true faith. God, remember, in His kingdom, our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, our Most Reverend Archbishop Metropolitan William, and our God, Living Bishop Curtin, the entire priestly, diaconal, monastic order, our government, and the local service of our country, and the ever memorable founders and benefactors of this holy church. May the Lord God remember in His kingdom the departed servant of God, Jan, for whom this liturgy is offered. May the Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith, always, now, and ever, and forever.
Oh.
Let us stand, right, let us stand and all, let us be attentive to offer the holy and accurate peace.
Mercy, peace, the sacrifice of grace.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts. Since through man sin entered the world and through sin death, so So it pleased your only begotten Son, who is in your bosom, God and Father, to be born of a woman, the holy Theotokos, and of her Virgin Mary, to be born under the law, to commit sin in his flesh, so that those who are dead in Adam might be brought to life in him, your Christ. Living in this world, he gave us precepts for salvation, turned us away from the deceit of idols, and brought us to know you, true God and Father. He purchased us for himself as a chosen people, a royal priesthood, and a holy nation, cleansing us with water and sanctifying us with the Holy Spirit. He surrendered himself as a ransom to death by which we were held captive, sold into slavery under sin. Descending by the cross into Hades to fulfill all things in himself, he freed us from death's despair and rose on the third day, preparing the way for the resurrection of all flesh from the dead. Since corruption could not keep the author of life in its clutches, he became the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep, the firstborn of the dead, that in all things he might have preeminence over all. Ascending into heaven, he has taken his seat at the right hand of your majesty on high, and will come to reward everyone according to his works. But he left us these memorials of his saving passion, which we have prepared according to his command, for when he was about to go forth to his voluntary, ever-memorable, life-fading death, on the night when he surrendered himself to the life of the world, he took bread into his holy and all pure hands, and presenting it to you, God and Father, he gave thanks, bless, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take it, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Likewise, taking the chalice of the fruit of the vine, he mixed and gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, drink of this, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Do this in remembrance of me, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this chalice, you proclaim my death and profess my resurrection. Therefore, O Master, we also remember the saving passion, the life-creating cross, the three-day burial, the resurrection from the dead, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement of your right hand, God and Father, in his glorious and fearsome second coming, offering you your own from your own ways and everywhere.
We praise you. We bless you. We thank you. Thank you, O Lord. And we praise you, our God.
O Holy Master, since you have allowed us sinners and unworthy servants to minister at your holy altar, not because of your righteousness, for we have done nothing good on earth, but because of your mercy and compassion so richly poured out upon us, we have the courage to approach your holy altar. As we offer you the holy body and blood of your Christ in this form, we pray you and beseech you, O Holy of Holies, that according to your kind favor, your Holy Spirit may come upon us and upon these gifts you offer, and bless and sanctify them, and show this bread to be the precious body of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, and this chalice to be truly the precious blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, shed for the life of the world, so that all of us who share this one bread and chalice may be united with one another in the communion of the one Holy Spirit, and that none of us partake of the Holy Body and blood of your Christ for judgment or condemnation. Rather, may we obtain mercy and grace together with all the saints who have pleased you since time began, the forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, teachers, and with every just spirit brought to perfection in faith. Especially for most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary.
In your womb, full of grace.
Among the first, O Lord, remember Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, our most reverend Bishop Paulton, William, our God-loving Bishop Curt, preserve them for your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and health. For many years that they faithfully impart the word of your truth.
And remember all your people.
Remember, O Lord, the entire episcopate of true believers who faithfully impart the word of your truth. Remember also my unworthiness, O Lord, according to the abundance of your mercies. Forgive me every transgression, voluntary and involuntary, and despite my sins, do not withhold any grace of your Holy Spirit from these gifts offered here. Remember, O Lord, the presbyter, the diaconate, and Christ, and every holy order. Let none of us who surround your holy altar be put to shame. Visit us with your goodness, O Lord. Reveal yourself to us in your rich compassion. Grant us a healthful and agreeable climate and gentle showers upon the earth, that it may be fruitful and crown the cycle of the seasons with your kindness. By the power of your Holy Spirit, bring an end to schism in the churches, extinguish the raging of the nations, and quickly put down the upsurges of heresy. Accept us all into your kindness, showing us to be children of the light and of the day. Grant us your peace and love, O Lord, our God, for you have given us everything. And grant that with one voice and one heart, we may glorify and praise your most honored and magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
May the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you. Now that we've commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts offered and consecrated that our God, who loves us all, may receive them on his holy, heavenly, and mystical altar, his robe and spiritual fragrance, and send that upon us in return his divine grace and the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for unity in the faith and for communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
You, O Lord.
God, the God of our salvation, teaches to give you worthy thanks for the bounties you have bestowed and continue to bestow on us. As you have accepted these gifts, O our God, purify us from every defilement of the flesh and the spirit. Teach us to grow perfect in holiness through the fear of you, so that with the pure testimony of our conscience we may receive the portion of your holy gifts and be united to the holy body and blood of your Christ. Receiving them worthily, may we have Christ living in our hearts and have become temples of your Holy Spirit. Especially, O our God, let none of us become guilty nor weakened in soul or body by partaking of these awesome and heavenly mysteries of yours unworthily. Rather, grant, O Lord, that even until our last breath, we may worthily receive a portion of your holy gifts as a provision for the journey to eternal life. And for an acceptable defense before the fearsome judgment sheet of our Christ. Then together with all the saints who have pleased you since time began, may we become partakers of the eternal blessings which you have prepared for those who love you, O Lord, and make us worthy, O Master, that we may with confidence and without condemnation do call you Father, God of heaven, and say, sins and for communion of the Holy Spirit, through the grace and mercies and the loving kindness of your living God. the Son, and pure of us, together with your Holy Good and Mighty Creator Spirit, now and ever and forever. holding this pure mortal, and the life creating in us the mysteries of Christ, let us worthily thank the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We thank you, O Lord our God, for our sharing in your holy most pure, immortal, and heavenly mysteries, which you have been given for us, which you have given us for the benefit, sanctification, and healing of our souls and bodies. You, O Master of all, grant that the communion of the holy body and blood of your Christ may bring about in us faith that cannot be confounded, a love that does not pretend, a wisdom that overflows, the healing of our souls and bodies, the defeat of every enemy, the full acceptance of your commandments, an acceptable defense before the piercing judgment seat of your Christ. For you are the our sanctification, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, and Father, O God and Father of glory, for our sake you gave us your only begotten Son, and through him you have made us your children, worthy again of the Holy Spirit. Have compassion on us now, for we have broken your commandments. Do not condemn us with those who have cut themselves off from you, nor leave us starved of your spiritual gifts. Instead, make us worthy to draw near to you by our words and in our hearts, and to prove by our deeds that we are your children, imitators of the conversion of the prodigal son, to whom you made known your love beyond expression to sinners. Grant that we may obtain the everlasting happiness which you have prepared for all who do your will, through the grace and mercy and love of my time, your only begotten Son, to whom glory is due, together with your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Church here in Raleigh. That will be here at St. Thomas Church on Sunday, March 19th from 5 o'clock until 8 o'clock in the evening. And that's open to all teenagers, Byzantine Catholic, Roman Catholic, and any teenagers. So please do pass the word around. There is going to be an Easter Basamki decorating class, an Easter egg decorating class with the traditional Basamki format to be used. And that's going to be Sunday, March 26th at 8:30 in the morning. So get up early in the morning, be part of the Basamki class, just so we can have enough supplies. There's a sign-up sheet in the back on the side of the church as you're exiting. Good news, Father Sparrow shall be returning once again to give us a Lenten retreat, and that will be Saturday, April Fool's Day. April the 1st, Saturday morning from 12:30 to 5 o'clock, and there's an information sheet in the back of the side of the church as well. Also, the profit and loss statement for the year 2021 is posted in the back of the church. We posted 2020 there last week and moved it off to the side by the TV. It's hanging on the TV set. But we put 2021 in its place, and so if you want extra copies of it, they are there for you as well. And next week we'll have 2022 out there. They're going to be all caught up. So here's the letter that Pastor Carmine sent us. He said, Jesus in the Gospel of St. Matthew says, "For I was hungry, you gave me food. I was thirsty, you gave me drink. I was a stranger, you welcomed me. I was naked, you clothed me. I was sick, you cared for me. I was in prison, you visited me." Dear siblings, you participated in Zion Rahway's Operation Warm Heart Homeless Ministry. In a very tangible sense, you may have, as the Book of Hebrews states, "Do not neglect to show hospitality to strangers, for so by doing, some have entertained angels without even knowing it." I, the people of Zion, Rahway, our team at Operation Warm Heart, and our guests at the shelter, thank you, all of you, for answering Jesus' high priest call to welcome strangers, feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty. Zion's Operation Warm Heart thanks are one thing, but it's another to know that in showing hospitality to strangers, you have above all shown hospitality to Jesus himself. God, we can be sure, thanks you. Whether this was your first or 10th season participating as a volunteer, this is our first time here at St. Thomas, I would be remiss if I did not point out that this ministry takes a lot of effort from so many generous people to keep it going, but it certainly takes less from us to give in return. It takes participants. I pray the feeling of having done life-saving work it is, so I thank you very much. The beauty of Operation Warm Heart Rahway is year after year, the wonderful people are filled with generosity. They come forward to do the work of helping people in dire need. Volunteers like you make this ministry work. Were it not for you, people would be left to sleep on the streets. In volunteering at the shelter, you may very well have saved someone's life. You should celebrate the work you have done. Thank you for blessing others and strangers with a generous spirit. And that's from Pastor Carmine, Meridian Zion Church. This week we're going to be giving them some food. A couple weeks ago we had some folks prepare food. We donated food from our own parish kitchen, but from the donations that you've been making as a surplus over the past couple of weeks, we're going to go out and get some food from local restaurants and kind of build on their generosity too and take it down to the shelter. So friends, I know I'm kind of going on and on about the shelter, but I've been doing that for a reason, because this is not a one-time thing. This is, homeless don't go away and hunger does not evaporate overnight. So we are really and truly making a difference in the lives of people. So I just want you to know that, okay? So thanks, Father, for indulging me and letting me have this time of making announcements. And God bless Father Tom and his family and all of you for being here. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Christ, daughter of hope, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now
true God, risen from the dead, and mercy on us and save us in the prayers of his most true mother, and of the holy, glorious, and illustrious apostles of the Holy Father, Basil, the great Archbishop of Caesarea and Cappadocia, of the holy apostle St. Thomas, patron of this church, of the holy great martyr of Conan, whose day lives and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ who stood and loves us all.
Father
Jim.